I think the thing that John and I have in common is we're both willing to take that leap into the unknown. And once you have that confidence, it's a great thing.
What's cool about this record to me is that it doesn't sound like Blaze of Glory at all, and it doesn't sound like a Bon Jovi record at all.
It's like, it is a new chapter. It's like no Bon Jovi project that I've worked on before.
I mean, John just sings his ass off. We do a few takes, and to me, they always sound great, so it's a pleasure doing vocals with Mr. Bon Jovi. He rocks.
Stage at the Academy Awards. My mother was there, my father, my grandmother, my wife, of course. And I'm performing, I'm looking out in the audience, and there's Pacino and Anthony Quinn and all, you know, these people. I'm going, this is pretty cool. I like it. And acting lessons was going to be an idea for me to get scripts so I could write songs for film. And one thing led to another until it took me about 2 years to even tell the band I was taking acting lessons, probably because I figured I'd quit or they'd give me shit about it, you know. And about 3.5 years into it, I auditioned for Moonlight and finally won my first role.
Ah, don't say a word. We know you don't speak any English. Your boss explained that it's perfectly okay.
Oh, what a great ass.
Alberta!
I love you.
I really hope that he understood that.
So do I.
I guess you guys were expecting Umberto.
Oh, no, I was expecting...
I'm flattered that you like my ass.
And on my way to the set the first day, we didn't rehearse. There was no time prior. In fact, when they flew me up there for rehearsals, the Stones were in town. And they said, do you know anybody that can get a Stones ticket? I said, oh, yeah. They blew off rehearsal. We went to the Stones show. So all these actresses were like jumping around, and I'm sitting in my seat going, great. You know, great.
I think I know why our friend left Hollywood. The word is the head of the studio caught him in bed with his wife. Robin decided it'd be a good idea to leave town for a while.
Basically, I just see this as doing a favor for a friend.
I want to know what restaurant she eats at. Where does she shop? Give me the bedroom first. I want to see her clothes.
For God's sake!
Tension and the suspense at the end. Have I really fallen for her or not? And I get to grab that gun. It's like, bang, bang, bang! You know, I mean, man, that's some climax.
I wrote the first 10 songs for what was to become this album in a trailer. And when you're on a movie set, people ask if you're gonna be bored to death because you have all those hours sitting around while they're setting up shots and rehearsing. I loved it because I could get away to a trailer, and for the first time in my life was truly somewhere where I was alone. You know, my whole adult life I've been married and had a wife and kids and a band. Before then, I lived with my folks, so I've never, ever been alone. And so those hours were precious. So I would sit in this trailer and write songs. Where I am in my life, the idea that anything is not too far out. You know, if it's working with the guys like Dave Stewart as producers or collaborators to doing films, to taking on a modeling job if I feel the need. It shouldn't be safe. Nothing's safe, nothing's sacred. We've been really blessed, you know, with the band for all those years to have achieved all these great successes, but comes a time when you have to walk away from it. and see if you can start over again. Every Word is just a song I'd written on the road with the band. It's a funny feeling, as successful as the band is and as happy as the band truly is, when I went off to do the Young Guns record, in retrospect, the truth is that the guys weren't really happy. This was a rock band that strived to be the biggest in the world, and that's what we did. So I wrote this song with the idea that I'm making no apologies. Here it is, this is what I did. And like it or don't like it, Every Word was all I had to give you. I've got my coat and my keys. I need you next to me, then I'm gone. Come on, destination anywhere. Name the place and I'll be there. Back to back and way out of here. Destination Anywhere was written in that trailer. God bless that trailer. I wanted to buy that trailer and put it in my backyard. You know, you got this big house, you go behind the house and there's a trailer. You go, that's where John lives, out in the shed. It's like when I went a couple times now on my motorcycle cross country, and it was truly Destination Anywhere. Anywhere you stopped, that was where you laid down at night. That's where you went to sleep. And that's where you met people, and that's where you saw things that you were, that were off the beaten path. There was no arena, there was no airport, there was none of the trappings of life in a rock band. I wanted to capture that in a song with the idea that I was going into this record and at this time in my life with the movies and everything else, that even as a father and married guy, just trying something new, something that was gonna push the boundaries a little. And it's just basically just as Destination Anywhere, left or right, I don't care.